Hello everyone, welcome back to my channel. Hope everyone is doing well. So today in this video I am going to talk about which ROM is best for Redmi Note 10s phone. Today I will talk about three types of ROM. One is a HyperOS 1.0 based ROM, and the other is HyperOS 2.0. The last one is the default ROM and the Pixel Experience type ROM. So let's start the video. First of all, I will discuss the HyperOS 1.0 based ROM. I have used many kinds of HyperOS 1.0 ROMs, some of which were Android 13 based, and most of the ROMs are Android 14 based. The ROM that you are currently seeing on your screen is HyperOS 1.0, which is based on Android 13. I have been using this ROM for a long time, and it is a very good ROM. This ROM has very good stable performance. Almost all the features of HyperOS are available in this ROM. Xiaomi alerts and Xiaomi message apps are available in this ROM, and this ROM is a global based ROM, so there will be no problem running the Play Store and any other apps. So now the ROM you are seeing on your screen is HyperOS 1.0 on top of Android 14, and I am using this ROM for a long time. I did not get any kind of problems like lag issues, hang issues from this ROM. This ROM is very good and very stable. I got all the latest functions and all the things is perfectly working on this ROM. And this ROM, the battery life and the game performance comparatively better. It has also the Xiaomi Dollar and Xiaomi Messages app, and it is also a global ROM. So if anyone told me which ROM of HyperOS 1.0 is best for Redmi Note 10s phone, then I will say you must try this ROM. Hope you get a good performance and get the best stability from this ROM. So now for those who need HyperOS 1.0 China based ROM, I have tried many kind of China based ROM, but they could not satisfy me. So I will say not to use the HyperOS 1.0 China ROM. But if anyone want to use a China ROM, then you can try this ROM, and which has comparatively fewer problems. Now I will talk about the ROMs of HyperOS 2.0, all of which are on top of Android 15. Some were definitely good, and while some were not usable, most of the ROMs that came were Chinese ROMs. Now the ROM that you are seeing on screen, this ROM is relatively good. This ROM give a good performance, but each of these ROMs that HyperOS 2.0 China base had battery drain issues, but this ROM is relatively less battery drain, and the performance of this ROM is really good. It has all kinds of HyperOS 2.0 features, and those who have used this ROM, they get a good performance and all the features is perfectly working. So I can say that if you need HyperOS 2.0 China based ROM, then you can definitely try this ROM. So then if I talk about HyperOS 2.0 global based ROM, I have tried many kind of HyperOS 2.0 global based ROM, but all them have some problems. Most of the problem are overheating and battery drain issue. So the ROM you are currently seeing on the screen is a global ROM, and I am currently using this ROM, which is on top of Android 15. This ROM is a good ROM. You will get all kind of HyperOS 2.0 functions is perfectly working. You will get the AI functions, has also the circle to search option and location customization, and all the things is perfectly working. So this ROM is a feature pack ROM, and the previous China ROM is also the feature pack ROM. So definitely you can try this ROM. So now I will talk about the default ROM of Redmi Note 10s phone. If anyone want to use the default official ROM, then I would say you can try the MIUI 14 based Indonesian ROM. Personally, I have tried the MIUI 14 based Indonesian ROM for a long time, and I get a good battery life and good performance from this one, and which is better than any other official ROM. I hope those who wants to use official ROM will try the MIUI 14 based Indonesian ROM. Hope you will get the good performance. So now I am talking about the Pixel Experience type ROM, cause many people is like to use stock Android. In stock Android, you will get slightly improvement in battery backup and camera, but there is a problem with the stock Android and Pixel Experience type ROM, cause this ROM battery backup is good, but The gaming performance of this ROM is not good. You will not get a good gaming performance from this ROM. So this is a problem with the Pixel Experience type ROM. And these ROMs have less features, but for those who need a lots of battery backup and prefer stock and net, you guys can easily try this ROM. If anyone asked me to suggest the Pixel Experience type ROM, I would say to definitely try the Linux OS 21. I used it for a few days and it is much better than any other Pixel Experience ROM. So you must check it out, the Linux OS 21. This ROM is really good. So hope you will get the good battery life and the performance from this ROM. More HyperOS 2.0 ROM are coming for Redmi Note Linux phone in future. So to know the review and the installation process of those ROMs, make sure to subscribe my channel and like the video. Hope everyone enjoy the video. If anyone does not understand something, you can definitely let me know in the comment box. If anyone needs to know more details, you can message me on Telegram. I will definitely try to help you.